thanks, Steve. I'm not sure what's left to say, but I was really honored when they asked me to come and present an award to my friend Chris Williamson. We've known each other for a long time, and I first met Chris in probably 1979, 1980. I was minding my own business at the Automat recording studios making records. And June Millington, who is probably best known for being the fierce rock and roll guitar player leader of Fanny, was producing a record for Chris. And June and I had known each other in Los Angeles, and so Olivia Records was in the Bay Area, and they asked me if I would engineer Chris's record. I said yes. I loved June and actually didn't really know much about Chris's music. That was really an incredible introduction to someone whose career has spanned so many years of recordings, so many different types of composing, so many eras from women's music to feminism to the social and political times that we have lived in over the last 30 plus years. And Chris has managed to capture the essence of all of those moments in such brilliant songwriting and such a brilliant performance, and yet she manages to keep the humanity of all of that in what she writes. Her background growing up in South Dakota and being on the farm, being far away from everyone, and how that wilderness and the West permeates her music really makes it a treasure to listen to. I remember when we were doing Strange Paradise at the Automat, and the piano we wanted to use was in the studio next door, so we put mics on it and had the wires coming into the control room we were in. And it's kind of interesting when you're an engineer and you watch somebody play, and you are sitting there fooling around with knobs and dials, or pots and pans, as Fred Gutierrez and I like to say. But when somebody's off in a room somewhere else and you can't see them, you can only really experience their artistry. And I think it was Marcy that we were recording, and it was just absolutely captivating and enchanting. And it was really hard to pay attention to the work I was supposed to do, because I would just close my eyes and listen to Chris sing and play. I've had the great fortune to have done Strange Paradise with Chris. I worked a little on Blue Rider. The only Holly Near Chris Williamson record that exists. I was lucky enough to do it, Skywalker, and then I co-produced with Chris Fringe, which was really a tribute to the West, and that was a thrill for me. She has paved the way for so many independent artists, men and women, gay and straight, the women's music movement, which, as Steve mentioned, was really the first time there was a concerted effort to get women to do all the jobs that had traditionally been done at record companies. And this was the beginning of the independent record movement, really, in San Francisco, between Olivia Records and Redwood Records. When I think about Changer and the Changed, which was, I think, is the 40th anniversary, I think about how much that record and Chris's career and her music changes everyone who listens to her music. So that album to me has really been so thematic for her whole career, and I think for the career of many of us. So it gives me great pleasure and so much honor to present the Far West Performer Award to Chris Williamson.